Hi everyone, my name is Duke of the Bump. Welcome to Let's Play Super Mario Land for the Game Boy. So, Dungeon Hack is still on the menu, so to speak. That'll be starting pretty soon. That's the next donation LP. It will be done as an LP, not as live streams. But in the meantime, I thought I would mess around with a series I haven't really messed around with that much. The Super Mario Land series eventually became the Wario series, and most of the games in that series are on handhelds. There was a Wario game on the Wii, I think, that I won't be able to look at, unfortunately, but other than that, I thought it'd be fun to go back and take a look at, you know, I mean, I'm a pretty big Mario aficionado, and this is a big blind spot and my Mario knowledge, so I thought it would be fun for us to go back and explore that together. Mario Land and Mario Land 2 for the Game Boy are, they're normal Mario, well, they're not normal. As you can probably already tell, this game is kind of weird, in ways I'll be getting into in a little bit. But Mario Land 1 and 2 starred Mario, and then after that, Wario took over as the protagonist of the series. Look at that. The can-can is the invincibility noise. I think that's the only time an actual piece of music has ever appeared in a Mario game. I don't know, I could be wrong, but yeah, there's just so many weird things about this game. This is actually the only game in the series that I've played a lot, because I actually owned this game on the Game Boy. My family had one of the original brick Game Boys, the big monster beast that took 4 double A's. And I played this game to death on it. We had this game and we had Tetris, and I think that was it. We never really got any other Game Boy games. Of course, you know, at the time, you know, when you're a kid, video games are kind of few and far between, so, you know, the games you have, you tend to play to death, and I did play this one to death. So you have two exits here, and if you make it to the top exit, which usually isn't that hard, then you get a cool little bonus stage here, where you can get some extra lives or a fire flower. You can sort of, control what you do here, but it's kind of tough to get Mario and the ladder in the exact right spot. See, what I want is a times 3 down at the bottom there, and I'm probably going to end up getting either the flower or the 2. Let's try it. Yep, flower. And it made a harsh noise because I already had the fire flower. So yeah, this game is my only experience with the Mario Land series, so after this, you know, it'll be totally new to me. I still haven't played this game in, like, 10... longer than that, like, 10 or 15 or maybe even 20 years. I don't know. It's been a long time. But I do remember this game pretty vividly, just from having played it so many times. If I remember correctly, this game is, like, 15 minutes long. And I don't even think that's that much of an exaggeration. So this might be like a one video LP. Maybe two videos. Three at the absolute most. I don't think it's that long though. I remember being pretty disappointed in the length of the game. But, you know, playing it several times regardless because, you know, you're a kid. You play what you have. Bunch of differences between this and the traditional Mario game. The Fire Flower is, I mean, doesn't really look like fire. It's a, there's no animation for firing it. And you can only have one projectile on the screen at a time. The 1-Up is a heart, because, you know, if it's a mushroom, obviously it's black and white, so you wouldn't be able to tell a power-up mushroom from a 1-Up mushroom, so they had to make it something. We've seen Goombas and Koopas, but the Koopas, they're like bomb turtles. When you jump on them, oops, their shell explodes. You can't kick it or anything. Which is pretty unusual. I'm kind of blowing through this here. This game is not very difficult, if I remember correctly. Ah, damn. One extra life, better than nothing. Aw, man, I remember this music. This is actually pretty good. This music is better than anything in New Super Mario Bros. The whole series. It's kind of a weird, like, pseudo-Egyptian theme going on in this whole game, I think. Or, no. It's, like, Egyptian, and then it's, like, different cultures, like historical cultures. I don't know. I mean, I'm sure as I play this game, the memories will come flooding back, but for now, I don't know. Like I said, it's been maybe 20 years. Oh, cool. Anything else in these? Man, everything about this game just feels weird. Like, it doesn't feel like a Mario game. But it doesn't really feel bad. I mean, the physics are okay. I feel like I'm in control of Mario. The speed on the sprite is actually pretty good. I don't feel like I have to hold the run button down the whole time like I do in, like, Super Mario Brothers. And the run isn't really that much faster than the walk, which is pretty nice. Kind of bare bones as far as, like, graphics and decorations go. I mean, this is one of the first Game Boy games, so it makes sense that it doesn't look as good as some of the more beloved and well-known Game Boy games. I hear this game get a lot of shit from people. Oh, I can't take the cool route. If I could go down there, there's like a buttload of coins. Well, I don't know. Can I, like, duck slide? Is that a thing in this game? I don't think so. Yeah. Nope. Oh well. Man, that's a lot of coins. Oh crap. Forgot about that. So of course, you know, playing this on the huge brick Game Boy. That system was notorious for hardly being able to tell what's going on the screen because everything is so blurry. They improved that later on with the Game Boy Pocket, but I never had that one. Just the 4AA monstrosity. Oh crap. Usually I have a fire flower when I get here, so I'm gonna have to do it the old fashioned way. I like that the bridge doesn't even collapse or anything. I just jump in that one spot and the boss explodes. So we have possibly the first bit of actual dialogue from Mario ever. He says, "Old Daisy," as Daisy transforms into some sort of hideous beast. Some sort of fly monster. Alright, well, the fire flower would actually be helpful now since I got hit. See if I can grab it. Oh, well, 3 extra lives. I'm not going to complain about that either. Alright, well, that was World 1. Took me a little longer because I was, you know, slowing down and explaining things. So, that'll do it. Tune in tomorrow for, hopefully, all of World 2. See you then.